guys, thank you so much for coming back to another motivational cleaning video. My name is Stephanie McQueen. I don't normally do sit down intros like this, but I just wanted to talk to you guys for a second before I get into all of the cleaning. First, I want to say thank you guys so much. I've been asking you guys to help me get to 5,000 subscribers, which is my first goal, and now I'm about 60 away and it's super exciting. So I'd love for you guys to continue to support, watch, like, comment, share, and subscribe if you're new. My whole intentions of doing this sit down intro is I never really expressed, I guess, my intentions or goals for my channel and how I really wanted to encourage other stay-at-home moms and wives. I believe that being a stay-at-home mom or wife is just grossly undermined in our culture today. I don't think a lot of people, you know, value it or look at it as something to be proud of. It's more of becoming a taboo thing. I've been so thankful and so happy to meet a large stay-at-home mom community on YouTube, which is so awesome and such a blessing. But I know in my real life, that is not a reality for me. You know, almost all my friends and everyone I know is a working mom and all that, which I love them and I'm so proud of them. And there's, you know, I don't have anything against working moms or wives or anything like that. But I just wanted to address the fact that I feel like stay-at-home moms and wives, or probably even if you're a dad, is super downgraded and not held to a high value, which I have learned from being a stay-at-home mom. You know, we play such an important role in our families' lives. As moms, we really hold the house together. You know, all the cooking and the cleaning and the taking care of the kids. We really are like that glue. Holds the whole family together. And I can definitely say that compared to when I worked full-time and went to college full-time, this is a lot harder. And it's so much work and you just never get a break. And at first, I felt ashamed of being a stay-at-home mom because people made me feel like that. And they were like, really, girl? Like, you wanna stay home? Like, why don't you go get a job and things like that? Or even on the aspect of like, you know, we struggle, you know, we have sacrificed a lot living off of one income so that I can stay home and take care of my daughter. And I also homeschool her as well. So that has been a huge sacrifice for my family. But, you know, I am proud to do it because I can see the rewards from doing it. A lot of stay-at-home moms these days are very isolated and very unsupported. And so I wanted to encourage you guys to be proud of what you're doing. You know, if you're cooking and cleaning and doing all that, it took me a while to kind of get into that mode of things. But now I look at my home and I feel very proud to decorate my home, to clean my home, to make it look nice, to keep it looking nice. And if you know me in real life, one of my biggest things is I love a good smelling home. Seriously, that is like my goal. I hate if my home smells bad. Most people will say, dang, Stephanie, I smelled your apartment when I walked up to the building. It smells so good in here. And I'm like, yes, you know, I win at that, you know? And that's something I'm very proud of. Or, you know, I don't live in the nicest apartment. I don't have this huge, beautiful home, and I haven't this whole time I've been on YouTube, but I still take pride in where I live and I try to decorate it as beautifully as I can and make it, as you know, something that my family can be proud of. And you know, people come over and they say, wow, Stephanie, your home is so beautiful, like, I don't know how you took this and made it look like that. And so I just want to encourage you guys to be proud of what you're doing. You know, you can be proud of cleaning your home. You can be proud of keeping it nice. You can be proud of, you know, all the cooking and all the work that you're doing, just because our culture says that it's not something that's, you know, really to be proud of anymore these days. You know, it used to be back in the day, but just really not in this culture. And I just want to tell you guys that it is okay to be proud of what you're doing. And so my goal is to really encourage you guys, no matter where you're at or what you're doing, or even if you live in the tiniest studio apartment, be proud of that and be proud of what you have and be proud of the fact that you're holding your family together. And it is something that is very rewarding. Enough of me rambling. I really hope that you guys enjoy this cleaning video and find it motivational. And please subscribe if you're new and like, comment, and share. Let's get started.
This is the one task that I have been completely avoiding, and that is my daughter's room. It looks really chaotic with her toys everywhere and just a lot of clutter and junk. Before we moved to this apartment, which we just moved about a month ago, my daughter's toys were completely organized and in different bins and stacked up in her closet. But in this room, we just do not have the space for that, and she kind of does have to minimalize on her toys. So I'm going to be decluttering her room and organizing all of her toys and just making it look better and everything fit better in her room. I'm also gonna say that this is all grandma's fault. And I don't even care that I'm saying that, because she knows that she obsessively buys my daughter's toys all the time. And I'm always like, Mom, we live in a small apartment and I don't have the room for it. But she doesn't care because she's obsessed with buying her toys, which I do love and I'm appreciative. But sorry, Mom, I have to get rid of some of these. I'd love for you guys to follow me over on Instagram at Steph_L McQueen. That is where I am most active on social media about my life.
Pick your most favorite Barbies that will all fit in that bin. So the ones that you don't want will go in here, okay? So they all have to fit in here, okay? Okay, so pick your favorite one so that we can put the lid on. What about her? Is she one of your favorites? Okay, Mulan? Okay, well, we'll put them right here. We'll put them nice right here. Okay, Mulan, is she one of your favorites? Okay. give away every toy. It's good to declutter. I didn't give away every toy. Look at all this that you're still keeping. We just need to be able to fit the lid on.
She does still have these two boxes that are filled with her knickknacks and books, and we just ordered some floating shelves, so we'll be able to put that up when they arrive. And here is all of her toys neatly stacked and in these bins, and now she will know what she has and where they're at. And then this is her little princess dress-up area that I just love for her so much. For one, I don't know why there's a sock on my counter. And for two, we have to keep our utensils right here because I don't know what happened, but my mother-in-law somehow broke this drawer off like completely. So now we're waiting for maintenance to bring us our new one.
Just wanna be inside, keep dancing in your mind. You'll be my All right, guys, that is all I have for this video. I will see you in the next one.